And we have also give some example when of a circuit, yeah, a simple circuit using operational amplifier, which is the unity gain buffer or what we call as voltage follower. We have derived the output as a function of the source input, yeah, using both the ideal model as well as the usual conventional linear model. And we have proven last week that there is no significant difference, only very slight difference. So that is why in most cases, yeah, in most cases when we are solving an operational amplifier problem, we use the ideal model. This is, for example, another case of inverting amplifier with a resistor 1 and resistor 2. Okay, so using the ideal model assumption, ideal model approximation here, it says, for example, the op-amp theory that the gain is infinity, so the V at the inverting, the V at the voltage, the potential at the inverting terminal should be the same as the voltage at the non-inverting terminal or the plus point. Since the non-inverting terminal is connected to the ground, it means that it is zero. It means also that the inverting voltage here is also zero. Then solving using, and the RI also is infinity, yeah, according to the ideal op-amp approximation. So it means there is no current flowing between the inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal. So it means no current flowing into the op-amp at all. Yeah, no current flowing in this wire, no current flowing in this wire. Yeah, I negative equals to I positive equals to zero ampere. So we can apply then Kirchhoff current law at this point B, at this node B of V negative, yeah, the negative, the inverting terminal, of which then Vs here minus zero because this is equals to zero, yeah, because of the ideal op-amp theory, divided by R1 plus V out negative zero divided by R2 equals to zero. This is KCL at this node B. So the gain from here will be V out over Vs, right? According to the questions, determine the gain G, V out over Vs. The gain will be equals to solving this AKCL will be equal then to negative R2 over R1. So this is using ideal op-amp approximation. Then last week we have also tried to solve this using the conventional linear model, okay, by identifying the op-amp nodes, redrawing the circuit, cutting the op-amp, okay, then drawing the components of the linear. So we draw an input impedance here. We draw also the output impedance at a V output and the voltage dependent voltage source, yeah, to the ground. And then after redrawing, we obtain this linear circuit model. And then, so this is the non-ideal case using node analysis at the different node here, V1 and V output, you obtain this matrix, and then we can solve using determinant, of which then we obtain this value, yeah, V output over Vs, the gain equals to negative R2 over R1 divided by this term. So when, and then we use the actual of M gain from the data sheet. If it has a gain of 10 to the power of 5 or 100,000 with an input resistance of 100 mega ohm and output resistance of 10 ohm, then we can calculate like this. So we obtain the V output over Vs is equal to negative 4.999694. So it's very close to minus 5, which we had calculated earlier using the ideal op-amp assumption. So see here, there are no significant difference. That is why in most cases, when we are solving op-amp circuit, we use the ideal op-amp approximation. Only when we need to really find the exact solution at how many digits, yeah, behind the point, then we use the linear algebra. Yeah, because if you use this in daily on in any cases, then it takes time, it takes maybe also some computing, yeah, computational power to solve these terms. Okay, so yeah, here the comparison between the non-ideal case, the actual linear model using the actual values from the op-amp, and this is the solution for ideal op-amp approximation. So very slight difference only. So ideal op-amp and non-ideal case. So in ideal op-amp, the current is zero. Yeah, there is no current flowing into the operational amplifier. The gain is infinity, so that then the potential difference, the potential difference between the op-amp input terminals is also zero. V plus equals to V minus. And at, when we ground one of the terminal here, for example, here the non-inverting terminal to reference, so it means the potential at the inverting terminal is also zero. So by using KCL, then we can obtain, calculate the gain V output over Vs equals to negative R2 over R1. So in non-ideal case, we replace this op-amp using the linear model, yeah, by applying Ri, the input impedance, input resistance, the voltage dependent voltage source, and the output impedance, and then put in the value from the actual data sheet. And then this is what we have. So the ideal op-amp assumption provides an excellent approximation. Yeah, unless forced, otherwise we will always use this ideal approximation, ideal assumption in any future cases. Another example here, one example, this is differential amplifier. So in differential amplifier, we would like to amplify the difference between two voltages inputted or inserted into the terminals, the inverting and non-inverting terminals of operational amplifier. Here in the inverting terminal, there is an R1 here connected to it, and there is a feedback resistor R2 from V out to the inverting terminal, and the non-inverting terminal is connected with R4 to the ground, okay, and connected to the input voltage V2 with R3 resistor. Okay, so what will be V output then? Then we can use the ideal op-amp assumption. First is we define the nodes here. So there is a node here between R1 and R2 and the inverting port of the op-amp. And there is node here, V plus, yeah, between R3, R4 and non-inverting node of the op-amp. And the final node here, V output node connected to R2. So since there are three nodes, three voltages, then we need three equations. Okay. The op-amp is defined by its three nodes. Hence, it needs three equations. KCL at V minus and V plus yield two equations. Infinite input resistance here implies that I minus and I plus are known. Okay. So output current here is not known. We do not use KCL at the output node. Okay. We get that equation from the infinite gain equation, which is V plus should be equals with V minus, yeah, because of the infinite gain at between the input terminals of the operational amplifier. So let's close this, and then notes at the inverting terminal here. So here, current from R1, current from R2. Okay, so no current into the operational amplifier. So V1 here, this is V1. Yeah, V1 minus V minus divided by R1 plus V output minus V minus divided by R2 equals to I minus. I minus here is the current flowing through the into the op-amp. Yeah. So this is not drawn here, but there is a branch here. So nodes at the non-inverting terminal at this node, yeah. V2 minus V plus divided by R3 equals to V V plus. This is zero, right? This is zero plus plus zero minus V plus, right? Then move to the right hand side of the equation, so equal to V plus over R4 plus I plus here. In ideal op-amp conditions, because of the infinite input resistance, infinite input impedance, there is no current flowing into the op-amp. So I plus equals to I minus equals to zero. And also because of the infinite input impedance, the V plus equals to V minus. Okay, this is the ideal op-amp condition. So from here, then we can calculate. We can redraw again. We can rewrite again the equations. I plus equals to zero here. So V plus equals to R4 divided by R3 plus R4 times V2. Okay, so V plus here move to here, and then we group V plus, and then this is what we obtain. V plus equals to R4 over R3 plus R4 times V2. V minus then will be the same, yeah, because V plus equals to V minus. So V minus also R4 over R3 plus R4 times V2. Then from this equation, then we can obtain V output equals to 1 of 1 plus R2 over R1 V minus, yeah, V minus R2 over R1 times V1. Okay, times V1, and then this can be regroup again. R2 over R1, regrouping R2 over R1, yeah, times 1 plus R1 over R2 times V minus V1. Okay. Then V output from here will be equals to the R2 over R1 times 1 plus R1 plus R2, and here we replace V minus here with this equation. So R4 over R3 plus R4 times V2 minus R2 over R1 V1. So here the V output will amplify the difference between V2 V, V minus with this multiplication factor, yeah, and this multiplication factor. Okay. And say if we make R4 to be equals to R2 and R1 to be equals to R3, so this can be simplified further. Okay. So this becomes V output equals to R2 over R1 V2 minus V1. R2 over R1 V2 minus V1, because this R3 we replace with R1, R4 is R2. And then we obtain this value. So here the condition is this one: R4 ground equals to R2, R3 here equals to R1. The input resistors to both terminals are made the same value, and the input resistor one the ground and to the output are also made the same value. So the V output will be an amplification of the difference between V2 and V1 multiplied by the ratio of these resistors. Okay. So if you see here, this is similar like a negative or inverting amplifier. Yeah, only now it is not grounded, the other voltage, but instead there is a potential here, V2. If V2 were grounded, if V2 here were grounded, so this is become zero, so V output will be R2 over R1 times negative V1. This will be the formula of an inverting amplifier as we have derived earlier in the previous slides. Okay, so this is a more general formula for a differential amplifier. So let's give an example again using ideal op-amp approximation. Find the V output here. So we have two operational amplifier here, V1 connected and V2, okay? And the output is connected to this resistor ladders, Okay, and the inverting terminal of the first op amp here is connected to this node. Inverting terminal of the second op amp is connected to this node. Yeah, so basically, since using ideal op amp approximation, there is no voltage difference between the two terminals, right? So this value here of this node is also V1. This value here is also V2. What will be then the output? The output. Okay, so this we identified node, yeah, V1 plus V1 minus, V2 plus V2 minus, V output 1, V in 1, V output 2, this is V in 2. Okay. Six node equation, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah. Six node equation plus minus 2 ideal of M because 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 and 2. So this is the same, yeah. Basically, there is no potential difference. So here we have to ideal of M. So now we close it. Yeah. So to just we just use the ideal of M approximation. V1 plus here will be equals to V1. V2 plus here will be also equal to this V2 minus equals to this V2. Okay, so this whole thing is basically the same potential. This is also the same potential using ideal op amp approximation. V1 minus will be equals to V in 1 here. V2 minus will be equal to V in 2. Okay, now finish with input node equation. We use the infinite gain assumption here. So V1 plus equals to V1 minus, this one equal to V1 minus, V2 plus here equals to V2 minus. So V in 1 here will be equals to V1. Yeah, V1 here basically is V1 plus or V1 minus, the same. V in 2 here will be equals to V2 plus or V2 minus, or here we just write it V2. Then there are the remaining node equation will be, so at this node, yeah, and then also the other node here. So at V in 1 here, yeah, V1, yeah, V1 minus V output 1 here, divided by current out, yeah, divided by R2 plus V1 minus V output 2. Yeah, here is the this one, yeah, V2, yeah, divided by RG plus V1 minus V output 2 here divided by R1 plus 0 equals to 0, yeah, because no current flowing, yeah, using the ideal of M assumption, because there is infinite impedance here at the input of the op amp, so there is no current flowing into the operational amplifier. So this current here equals to 0, that's why this plus 0 equals to 0. Yeah, so this the other three branch is from this branch, and this branch. So at V into V2 minus VO2 here, yeah, divided by R1 plus V2 minus V1 divided by RG plus V2 minus 0 divided by R2 plus 0 here, yeah, equals to 0. So this is also no current. Yeah, because of the ideal of M assumption of the infinite gain, so it means no input currents to the operational amplifier. Now the only unknowns are the output node voltages here. So solve for the required here from these two equations, we solve for the required variable V output equals to VO1. So this one, this part, okay. So from here, then we obtain V output equals to V1 minus V2 multiplied by 1 plus R2 over R1 plus 2 R2 over RG. Okay, so how to solve this? Yeah, this is VO1 equals to the V output, right? VO1 equals to the V output. So the other terms you can replace, for example, with this equation, or by substituting or elimination. Okay, so another example here, we have now with values. Determine the IO at this resistor, yeah, 10 kilo ohm resistor connected to the V output of an op amp. We assume again ideal op amp. We are assuming an ideal op amp. So V plus here, yeah, at the non-inverting terminal is 12 volt. V, so with infinite gain, it means that V minus here is also 12 volt. So here, the potential here is also 12 volt. Okay, the V minus here equals to 12 volt because it is connected. They're connected. The current here will be zero because of the infinite gain, infinite gain or the very high input impedance, yeah, Ri equals to infinity. So this I minus here equals to zero. I plus here will be also equals to zero. So KCL at this node, V minus, it will be 12 minus V output over 12 kilo ohm plus 12 minus zero over 2 kilo ohm equals to zero. So from which we obtain V output equals to 84 volt, okay, 84 volt. So now calculating the current is quite easy. You just use Ohm's law because this is grounded, right? So the output divided by 10 kilo ohm. We obtain the current output current equals to 8.4 milliampere. Now this is a non-inverting amplifier circuit. Why? Because the input voltage is connected to the non-inverting terminal, the plus terminal of the operational amplifier, while the negative terminal, the inverting input, is being grounded, connected to R1, yeah, the when connected to a feedback resistor also to V output. So we use ideal op amp approximation again. So this will be V plus and this V minus is V output. Okay, using ideal op amp, V plus will be equals to V minus. So the note here will be equals to the V in here. Okay, V negative equals to V1, yeah, V1 here, using the infinite gain assumption. And the current flowing here will be zero. Current flowing here is also zero. The node here then will be equals to, the VI here will be equals to V minus, okay? And this is the V output. This is an inverse voltage divider formula, yeah, because this is the V input, this is the V output now. So you are looking the V output. So the V output will be, if V1 here from voltage divided formula is R1 over R1 plus R2 times V output, right? So in first voltage divider means that the V output equals to R1 plus R2 divided by R1 times V input. So you just input the value, then you will have the value of the V output. Okay, so now find gain and the input resistance. Input resistance here, and also you are asked to find the gain, non-ideal op amp. So in this case, then you have to use the linear circuit approximation of the operational amplifier. Yeah, using the input resistance, the voltage-dependent voltage source, as well as the output resistance. V input equals here, to the V plus minus V minus. So this is basically the same, yeah, the non-inverting amplifier problem. Determine the equivalent circuit using linear model for operational amplifier. Now we identify first the nodes, so V plus, V minus, and V output. Then here this is the op amp. The op amp we replace with the linear circuit model of operational amplifier. There is an input impedance or input resistance connecting between the non-inverting terminal and the inverting terminal. And at the output, it is connected to the output impedance and the voltage controlled voltage source, okay? A times V plus minus V minus. You have to redraw the circuit here to enhance the clarity so that we can solve it. Yeah, and we have this as the redrawn circuit, okay? This is the RI coming from here. This is the node. This node is same like this node. So here the voltage at here is the V input, yeah, V plus which is V plus minus V minus. This is R1, this is R2, connected to the V output. So V output is here. Yeah. The potential here relative to the ground or the reference. And this is connected to RO, the output resistance of the op-amp, and the voltage source, the voltage-dependent voltage source of the op-amp. So here there are two mesh. So we use mesh analysis. The mesh one here minus V1. So we put it into the other side of the equation, so become V1. So equals to I1 times R1. Ri, then I plus I1 times R1 here, minus I2, because this is there is a opposing current from I2 flowing through the R1, minus I2 times R1. At mesh 2 here, the loop is clockwise direction here, so if Vi, then we put to the other side of the equation, becomes negative. If Vi equals to minus I1 R1 from here, plus I2 times R2 plus RO, okay? R1 plus, and also plus R1 as well, R1 plus R2 plus RO. So from here, the controlling variables here will be this V in, yeah, V plus minus V minus, yeah, V plus minus V minus. So V input equals to the RI times the I1, yeah, here. So this input impedance, input resistance times the current one, I1. So we can replace our R1, RI I1 can be replaced with this value, because what we want to know is the V output over V1 value, yeah, the gain as well as later the input impedance. So V output equals to here minus R2 I2 from here, yeah, here I minus R2 I2 plus R1, yeah, plus R1 times I1 minus I2 V output. So we calculate from this, yeah, from here, yeah, so this will be the negative I2, right, because the I2 flowing through here, but we calculate from here, this point to this point. So negative I2 times R2, and this point would be I1 R1, I1 minus I2 times R1. That is the value of V output. So we obtain from mesh 1 this value, from mesh 2 this value, the controlling variable we rewrite again from the previous slide. We obtain, this is the V output. The input resistance is Rin. Yeah, Rin is V1 minus this V1 minus I1. Okay. And the gain is V output divided by V input. Yeah. So this divided by this. Replacing and put in the matrix form from this two mesh equation, this is what we obtain. Then this is the formal solution. So we can use then MATLAB or Octave, yeah, to calculate when we know the value of R1 and R2 and RO. Then this is the determinant, the value of the determinant, and the adjunct, yeah, the adjoint of the matrix. We also calculate from this value, and we find the solution I1, I2 over 1 over delta, the determinant times the adjoint. If you use MATLAB or Octave, this will be straightforward. This can be calculated quite straightforward. So from here, we obtain I1 to be equals to R1, R2, RO, divided by the determinant times V1, and I2 equals to negative ARI minus RI times divided by I2, times V1, yeah, and then divided by delta. So Rin, the input impedance from here can be calculated from this value, V1 divided by I1. So, and then we obtain this value. And V output can be also calculated later as this this one. Okay, negative R2 R2, I2 plus R1, I1 minus I2. So here we insert from this solution of the matrix equations. Now, how to calculate the gain? If the gain is approaches infinity, then the determinant will be equals to A times R1 times Ri. So the Rn will be approaches to infinity as well. The gain is V output over V1. So V output over V1, yeah, then we obtain, so this divided by this one. So we obtain this and this, and it will be approaching this value R1 plus R2 over R1. This is basically what you will have when you solve that circuit using ideal op-amp approximation. Okay, then a semi-ideal op-amp model. This is an intermediate model, more accurate than the ideal op-amp model, but simpler than the linear model used so far. So Ri equals to infinity in this case. Yeah. Ro equals to zero. The output impedance is made zero. The input impedance or input resistance is infinity, so still the same. However, the gain is not infinity. It has some value, Ao. So I plus equals to I minus equals to zero. So because of the infinity input resistance, there is why no current flowing into the op-amp. However, in this case, since the gain is not equal to infinity, then V plus is not equal to V minus. And instead, we have to replace the equation with V output equals to AO times the V E equals to A output times the difference between the voltages from the inverting and non-inverting terminals. Okay, so if we have, for example, this is non-inverting amplifier circuit, yeah, then this we replace with V in, which is V plus negative V minus, and then we replace there is no R in. Yeah, R in is open circuit because it is infinity. RO, there is no RO also. RO is zero, so it means it is short circuited. But we have only this voltage dependent voltage source, yeah, AO times the V in. V in here equals to the difference between the V source here, the V plus minus V minus. Yeah, this is semi-ideal model. This is a non-inverting amplifier circuit. So from here we obtain V plus equals to the V source. Then V output will be equals to from here R2 over R2 plus R1 times V minus as before. So this is, we know this is the inverse of the voltage divider formula. Yeah, inverse voltage divider formula. Then we know that VO equals to AO times VS minus V minus. Yeah, we replace V plus with V minus here. Then V plus with VS actually, yeah, VS here. So then V output over VS will be equals to AO divided by 1 plus AO times beta, where here beta equals to R1 over R1 plus R2. Okay, R1. So GE in this case is the gain ratio here. The actual gain, ideal gain, divided by the actual gain minus ideal gain divided by ideal gain. The difference between the actual gain calculated using this semi-ideal op amp minus the ideal gain, the gain when it is calculated using ideal op amp assumption, divided by the ideal gain. In this case, the value is 1 over 1 plus AO times beta. So beta here is R1 over R1 plus R2. We will continue, by the way. Yeah? So first hour and second hour will be combined. So we will have a break about 11:15. Yeah? Okay, so let's have a sample problem here to solve using the ideal op amp solution. Find the expression for V output. Indicate where and how you are using the ideal op amp assumption. So this is the V source is connected to the non-inverting terminal of the op amp. There is a current source here connected to the inverting terminal of the op amp as well as to the feedback from the V output with a resistor R. Okay, so V plus equals to V source. And use, this is ideal op amp assumption, so we use the infinite gain assumption. So the V minus will be equals to the V plus, so equals to the V source. Okay. Use infinite input resistance assumption, so it means no current flowing to both terminals. And we then apply Kirchhoff current law at the inverting input. Here, so IS plus V output minus V minus here divided by R equals to zero. Yeah. Since V minus is equals to V source, okay, so from here then we obtain this is negative IS, negative RIS, V output equals to VS negative RIS. Okay. Another sample problem. Draw the linear equivalent circuit and write the loop equation. So here we have to use the non-ideal approximation. Locate the nodes, this node, yeah, and this node connected, and this node, the output voltage. We erase the op-amp, then we replace with the linear model of the op-amp. Yeah, between plus and minus terminals of the op amp, we connect with input resistance. And at the output node, we connect with output resistance as well as with the voltage dependent voltage source, A times V plus minus V minus. Then we redraw it. So it becomes like this. Okay. The question is this RO. So we have two meshes, two loops, one current source. So we use mesh like this. I1 will be equals to IS. So at mesh 2, RI times I2 minus IS plus R plus RO times I2, then plus this is a voltage A times V plus minus V minus. Okay. The controlling variable here, V plus V minus equals to RI. Yeah, times I2 minus I1. Okay, this is for the voltage across RI. Okay, let's now find, give another example of op-amp with values now. This is connected to 1 millivolt voltage source to the non-inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. The inverting terminal is connected to 1 kilo ohm and 100 kilo ohm to the feedback to the output. Then this one is connected to ground. The question is, what is V output? Find the gain of the overall circuit and the V output. So using ideal op amp assumption, so this is V plus equals to V source. The V minus will be equals to V source also because of in ideal op amp assumption, the the gain is infinity, right? So V plus equals to V minus. So since the infinite in ideal op amp, the resistance input, the input resistance is also infinite. So I minus equals to zero. I plus here is also equals to zero. So basically this is a full inverse voltage divider. Yeah. So this has become V source at this node and connected to a voltage divider R1 and R2. This is 1 kilo ohm and this is 100 kilo ohms. So V output can be calculated using the inverse voltage divider. V output equals to 100K plus 1K divided by 1K. 101 divided by 1. So 101 times of the V source. The gain is 101. Then V output here will be equals to, if the V source is, 1 millivolt, so the V output 1 millivolt times 101. Or becomes 0.1014. Yeah, this is an amplifier, non-inverting amplifier. Okay, another example. Under ideal conditions, we have this voltage here, V1, V2. This is connected. This is also a non-inverting amplifier. This is connected to, so there are amplified both two times. If 1 volt is less than V1 and V1 is less than 2 volt, 2 volt is less than V2 here, V2 is less than 3 volt. So V2 is between 2 and 3 volt. The DC supplies are plus minus 10 volt. Under ideal conditions, both circuits satisfy V output 8 V1 minus 4 V2. Determine if both implementation produce the full range for the output. So we have two implementation here. This first, this is a cascading non-inverting amplifier connected in series. And we have here first amplifying V1. This is using non-inverting. This is inverting amplifier. This is non-inverting amplifier. Then it is connected, added to this inverting amplifier, then being amplified here. This is our different kind of two amplifiers, but with the same purpose to produce this value. So in this first circuit, Vx will be equals to 2V1 minus V2. Yeah, we can derive it further. So if we like, so basically this is the same as this voltage divider. Yeah, this is inverting amplifier. The difference is now it is not grounded at this point, but instead it has a value V2. Okay, so that is why, and this 10 to 10 kilo ohm, yeah, so this 2 times amplification of V1, since this is not grounded, if it is grounded, this will be minus 0, right, from the previous slide. So this is V equal minus V2, okay, this Vx. Of course, we can derive it, but for the sake of time, we just move on to the next discussion. So the value of V1 is between 1 volt and 2 volt. The value of V2 is between 2 volt and 3 volt. So from here, Vx, from this value, becomes between minus 1 volt to 2 volt. How could we get this? Yeah. So set for the minimum value here, then we have to take the largest V1. The largest V1 will be 2 volt, right? So the largest V1 of 2 volt, Vx will be 2 times 2 minus this, and the smallest, the smallest V1, sorry. And for the smallest value here, then we calculate from the smallest V1, so that will be 1 volt to 2 times 1, and take the largest V2. Largest V2 is 3 volt, minus 3. Okay, so this becomes 2 minus 3 is negative 1 volt. So to obtain the smallest difference, okay, this is smallest difference, small or minimum difference. Maximum difference here, I put different color. Maximum difference here. Maximum Vx will be obtained when we take the largest value of V1, which is 2 volt, right? 2 times 2 minus the smallest value of V2 minus 2 volt here. So equals to 4 minus 2 is 2 volt. So this is how it plays. So Vx, the value of Vx is between this minus 1 volt and 2 volt. Okay, this is how we obtain this value. I hope it's quite understandable. So here the V output will be equals to, wait, let me erase first. So the V output here, this is a non-inverting amplifier. So basically this is 4 times. Yeah, this is a non-inverse voltage divider formulas as derived earlier. So 4 times of Vx, okay, 4 times of Vx. Yeah, so here Vx basically equals to 10k over 10k plus 30k times V output, right? So 1 over 4 Vx equals to 1 over 4 V output. V output equals to 4 times Vx. Yeah, this is how we obtain this. It's basically the same as the previous slide. Okay, let's clear first again. So from minus 1 volt to Vx, if the Vx is between minus 1 and 2 volt, the value of V output will be, this is minus 1 times 4 is minus 4 volt, and 2 volt times 4 equals to 8 volt. So the V output will be between minus 4 volt, less than V output, less than or equal to V output, and V output equals to less than equals 8 volt. The DC supplies are plus minus 10 volt. So this still, this amplified value is still between within the values of the DC supplies of the operational amplifier, the VCC and VEE. Yeah. So it means that it is okay. The value why it is okay. Yeah. So see here, because the question is determine if both implementation produce the full range for the output. Yeah, this is D. Okay, now in this case, the second circuit implementation, Vy here, so this is an inverting amplifier, will be equals to negative 80 over 10. Okay, right, 8 times. So Vy equals to minus 8 V1. V2 here, Vz, okay, this is an inverting amplifier. This is a voltage divider, remember, in this one. So this is Vz will be equals to 4 times V2, right? So here, 1 volt less than V1, less than 2 volt, V1 between 1 and 2 volt, it means Vy will be equal to times 8. So this becomes minus 16 minus 8. Yeah, minus 8. So minus 8 times 1 is minus 8 volt. Minus 8 times 2 is minus 16 volt. So the value of Vy will be between minus 16 volt and minus 8 volt, but it is being inverted, yeah, in polarity. However, now minus 16 volt already exceeds supply value. The supply value is plus minus 10 volt, right? So it cannot. So the energy is always conserved. You cannot amplify the voltage larger than the DC power supplies to that operational amplifier. Why op amp can amplify? Because of this additional voltage supply from the VCC and VEE. Because remember the first lecture, yeah, the first lecture on op amp last week. So since this is exceeding already the minus 10 volt value, so this op amp will saturate. So this cannot be used, yeah, to amplify the voltage into the this value. Okay. Okay, then we have comparator circuit. Comparator circuits. Comparator circuits compare between the voltage at the plus and minus. And then when V plus and V minus, when it is exceed certain value, it will turn one or negative one, something like that, like a switch. Yeah, so when V plus is larger than V minus, here V output will be equal to VCC. But when V plus is less than V minus, V output will be equals to VEE or negative VCC. Okay, so this is used to compare the two values of an analog. Basically, it is already like a computer, the analog computer. Then we have the zero crossing detector. So VS here, yeah, the input is this one. When the input is above, so basically this is a kind of comparator also, but the V minus is made zero. Okay, so when the source is above the zero value, when V source is above zero, then it will switch on. Yeah, the output will be on or one. When the value is negative, it will be negative. Something like that. It's like the value of the VEE. So here the VCC is plus 5 volt, the VEE is negative 5 volt, Okay. So the, when it is above, when the sinusoidal value is above zero, then the value of the output will be 5 volt. When it is below zero or negative, the value will be negative 5 volt. Yeah, this is a zero crossing detector, or basically it is also a comparator, yeah, but with the V minus value set to zero. Some real op amps requires a pull up resistor. Yeah, this is what we call as a pull up resistor, the 3 kilo ohm. Okay, so cannot just directly like this, but instead we have to put a resistor between the V output and or the VCC and the V output. Okay, so this is an op-amp based ammeter, yeah, the application of op-amp based ammeter or ampere meter. If we have an unknown current, we want to measure it. So what we do is we convert or that current into voltage so that then we can measure it using the usual voltmeter. Okay, so by using op-amp, we can convert that unknown current. So for example, this unknown current, and there is a resistor here, so the V1 here will be equals to that current, yeah, multiplied by the resistor, yeah. So for example here, if the resistor 1 is 1 kilo ohm, this is basically also non-inverting amplifier, yeah, with voltage divider R1 and R2. R1 is 1 kilo ohm as well. Yeah, non-inverting amplifier, the gain here will be 1 plus R2 over R1, yeah, or basically a inverse of voltage divider, yeah, R1 plus R2 divided by R1 again, yeah, as we have derived in the previous slide. So V1 here will be equals to VI, yeah, V input will be equals to R input times the current. Okay, so then the V output will be equals to G, the gain, times this input voltage, or 1 plus R2 over R1 times RI, yeah, times the input current. Okay, so since R2, R1, RI is known, so this become a constant of the fan constant of the current. So a conversion factor from the current into voltage with a gain. So in sensor application, we can use this when the sensor output is current instead of voltage. For example, in which sensor? Yeah, some sensor. I cannot say it now. But if you want, then to, because most of if you use microcontroller to make it digital, yeah, then we have to convert first the current output of that sensor into voltage. Then we can use this kind of op-amp circuit to convert that current into voltage with a gain. Okay, so this is DC motor control. If you see it, 5 volt. Then, yeah, this is previous example. Yeah. Choose non-inverting amplifier here with power of M, PA03. So this is with non-inverting amplifier which has this kind of circuit, RB and RA. The gain will be 1 plus RB over RA. So it is equal 4 because here it wants the gain to be 4, yeah, Vm. The voltage here should be 4 times of the V speed here. The constraints is that the Vm should be less than 12 volt. Power dissipation in the amplifier should also be less than or equal to 100 milliwatt. Simplifying the assumption, yeah, by using ideal of M assumption, our input gain here should be infinity. The output gain should be, the output resistance should be zero. Input resistance should be infinite, output resistance should be zero. No significant power loss only occurs at RA and RB. So worst case scenario occurs when the Vm equals to 20, the Vm here equals to 20, and the DC motor voltage itself. So Pmx power at the motor will be 12 volts square divided by RA plus RB should be less than or equal to 100 milliwatt. So from here, then we obtain that RA RB should be this is one for 420. So 400, yeah, 400 divided by 100 milliwatt. So RA RB should be larger than or equal to 4000 ohm, the sum of the RA and RB. Okay. So from here, then we obtain RB over RA. It should be 4 minus 1 equals to 3. Okay. So means that RB should be 3 times RA, and the value should be larger than 4000 ohm. If we use RB equals to 3 kilo ohm and RA equals to 1 kilo ohm, yeah, which fulfill this condition, and the addition of 2 will still be fulfilling this condition, yeah, should be larger than or equal to 4000 ohm. This 3 kilo ohm plus 1 kilo ohm equals to 4 kilo ohm. The standard value is at 5%. Okay, so let's have a break because it's already 11:15, and I'm sure you are already eager to do the quiz. First, let me stop the recording. So we will continue the preparation.